On the second day of Yule, Ivy Corvus gave to us altar or decorations for Yule. Hello, witches, and welcome back to A Coven of Two, where we discuss witchcraft and activism. You can call me Isha, my pronouns are she, they, and in this video, indeed, we are on the second day of Yule, of the 12 days of Yule that Ivy the Occultist started. And today is about sharing your altar or decorations for Yule. But before we get started, let me mention that I've opened a coffee, which is basically an alternative to Patreon that takes less from creators. And on there, you can do a one-off donation or a monthly subscription donation to support the work that I do here. And you can also get tarot readings, donate what you can from £5 onwards, and you can get a tarot reading with me, Italian style. So if you would like to support what I do here, you can head on to coffee. And if you do so, thank you so much. And other than having my tree that says Pride and trans rights specifically, because it's a white tree with light blue and light pink bubbles, I also have made a Yule log, as I mentioned yesterday. My coven came around on the 17th of December because this year I was hosting Yule. And it wasn't my idea. Like, I wish I had a cool idea like, oh, let's make Yule logs. No, it was Raven's idea. And I'm personally not a very crafty person. But we were like, ah, how hard can it possibly be? So we got together, we got glue guns, we got pyrographer, actually, that we had never used before, but very interestingly, we did for this occasion. And then everybody brought different decorations. Our friend Tony brought all crystals to use, couple we used as well. Harriet brought all the evergreens that they found and gathered. There were so many nice things. And ours is relatively essential and I think reflects our existence in general. It's very, in a way, Venus-centric. And I like it and I support it. She's been giving us incredible support, I feel, in the last few months. So it was only fair to focus on that. And that is the decoration, the main decoration that we have realistically. I do not have altars that change with the season or with the will of the year. The main two altars that I have in the house are the one for Vesta, which is on my electric fireplace, and I have one for Venus, which is on a chest of drawers. Technically, I have a small one just with the four elements that I use during spells. So if I cast a circle, if I do the lesser banishing ritual of the pentagram, I do it there, but it's just very, very essential so that I can also clean it. My cat jumps on it a lot, so it needs cleaning, but I don't necessarily do different altars just for the different Sabbaths. But the decoration that I've done is indeed, these, look at it, and pretty. You'll see it better with all the beer roll. But basically what we did was we got some of the evergreen that Harriet brought. I got two amethyst and an hematite from the crystals that Tony brought. We put some, it's not tinsel, it's just ribbon, because the tinsel was all gone. And then we have a piece of dried lavender, and we sprinkled some incense on it that my friend Paul brought, which was called Venus incense. So yes, of course, please more. The candles are two for friendship, one for love, passion, energy, the red one. And then we sprinkled, we let the wax of a white candle drop, because it gives a very, very nice snow effect. And then, because Raven started to test with the pyrographer, and I think it was amazingly done, she not only made a pentacle on one side, but also a sigil with our initials there. So I think that's actually very, very beautiful. And then, we weren't done yet. There are the copper-made hearts that we glued on it, and then copper Polaroids holder, and we took the Polaroids with each of us in front of the Venus altar, hopefully to foresee this kind of love that goes on and develops and it keeps us safe and keeps us nurtured and protected throughout the entire year to come. I I wanted to quickly mention that something that I found really interesting was a reel that Rachel Henderson, who wrote The Scent of Lemon of Rosemary, the book about Hestia, and she shared it on Instagram. And it was a great idea about making your Yule tree as an altar with offerings. So I'll link her reel to it. One of the most interesting parts for me was not only how you decorate it and every piece of decoration represents or means something, but especially if you have candy canes and you put the candy canes as decorations, those also count as offerings for the spirits of the house. And I thought it was a lovely idea, so I'm gonna link it. I might think maybe in the future to do it as well. I hope this was useful, and I am really, really curious to hear about your Yule decorations, your Yule altar. I don't make it, but what do you put on your Yule altar? Do you change the decorations? Do your decorations expand beyond the altar and you go a bit crazy like I do? Or like you're much more chilled and leveled and adult than I am? I'm really curious. Let me know. Link me pictures if you'd like to share. And I will see you in tomorrow's video, which is going to be all about reflecting of this last year of practice, which in a way for me is almost my entire year and beginning of practice. So we'll see. It's a time of reflection and looking back so that we know where we go forward. So until then, I hope that we can ex the patriarchy together, because there's need for it.